siento mucho porque...
No. Quins? Els efectes de la... Ah, val, ho diré. Gràcies, sí.
No, perdoneu. Me sabe muy mal tenerte que interrumpir porque yo creo que ha sido una conferencia súper interesante y nos hemos quedado con las ganas de poder tener más tiempo para escucharlo, ¿no? Pero bueno, espero que podamos tener la oportunidad de verlo con más calma, aunque sean nuestros propios ordenadores. I'm sorry.
No problem. Sí. I'm ready for
Entonces, lo que sí tenemos es nada, unos minutos escasos, porque hemos alargado al máximo el tiempo para darle la palabra a Anupama para hacerle algún comentario o alguna pregunta que vosotros queráis. Y me están comentando también desde la logística que por favor bajéis los volúmenes de vuestros aparatos porque si no parece ser que tiene problemas para las traducciones y para escuchar, ¿vale? Pues si alguien quiere decir algo, tiene alguna pregunta para hacerle a Anupama, pues aprovechen estos minutos porque son escasos pero muy interesantes. Sí. Pues.
Dice que va a Madrid.
Sí.
Disculpo porque esta mañana no pude venir, pero dices que vas a Madrid. ¿Es por un proyecto o es para alguna universidad?
Universidad.
Ella está viviendo en Madrid ahora.
Sí, pero no sé si se había trasladado por motivos de trabajo para construir algo o por algún encargo o si era para docencia.
I think there are a lot of Spanish architects who don't have enough work and that they are very good architects and I'm not really trying to be part of, you know, that so much. I'm here because I have this, my family moved to live here because of this kind of teaching job, but it's also personal. My husband is Spanish. Some of you don't know that. Maybe you know, because in Spain everybody knows everybody. It's a village. So that was the main reason. And I think that many people ask me, why are you going there during the crisis? And, you know, but I was all my life in the crisis, so I'm not afraid about it. It's good for my children to be with the grandparents and to... It's good. I'm very happy to be here because it is not a poor thing for me. It's a richness of... In architecture, you are very rich. So for me, to spend my life and time with people of a high level of awareness is a very fulfilling thing. I have a lot of work still in India and teaching, and I'm quite busy. So I don't know, but I would like to work in Spain, maybe with all your kind of groups.
Thank you. ¿Alguna otra pregunta, quizá?
Hola, buenas tardes. Más que una pregunta, es una felicitación y un agradecimiento por tu trabajo que es inspirador para muchas personas. Simplemente agradecerte que seas tú misma, que siempre que somos nosotros mismos podemos sacar muchas cosas adelante. Gracias.
Thank you also. Yeah, I'm also happy to be here in this conference. Actually, I find one of the few time I'm taking back a lot from the place, you know, from everything, everybody, you know, and so I'm very happy to be here also. Thank you.
¿Alguna cosa más? Sí, allí.
¿Hablo en castellano?
Yes.
Sorry, I'm going to talk to you in English.
No, I think she's translating. Sorry, you get a break.
I feel...
I can understand a bit.
Yeah. I just feel weird to speak to you in Spanish. Anyway, my question would be, like, coming from Indian, you say that, and I've seen that you've been teaching in London, and you see the difference between London reality, which is a very capitalist city with where the interests and the efforts are always very related to money. And coming from India and being now in Spain, how do you know, how do you see how to put all this in balance? How in those places that are so rich, where within architecture world, everything seems to be driven by how much money can we make?
But even in India it's the same.
Okay.
You know, everywhere human nature has the same, even from centuries, we have good feelings and we have greedy behavior, and this is everywhere. The big difference that I see between developing countries and developing countries is that the industrialization, the time you developed your cities during industrialization, it has set some patterns and some habits of standardization which can have advantage and also disadvantage. And that's the main difference I see. But otherwise we are quite similar. We have in India also, we have like in New York and the rest of America, there's a big gap, similarly with Bombay. And so everywhere is everything. I find it very quite common actually overall. If you, it depends how you look at it. The more I travel, I feel we are all quite similar. There is some contextual differences, but in the underlying human nature behind it is exactly quite the same, I feel. So it helps me to, I have learned things how to survive in difficulties in India, because there are, I was exposed to more difficulty. That's why I am not afraid in the another place, where many people think that it's very difficult to do innovation and all. I don't think it's difficult, you know. It's not more difficult. It's just that I'm not blocking myself, because I know that no one is going to do. I'm used to being self-reliant. I'm used to creating everything from scratch. If I go to buy a dress, I have to buy the cloth first and I have to think what to. So I'm used to that. And others can also do it, but they think they can't do it. It's just a lack of, I think, of imagination or but you know, it's even here there are people who know how to knit their sweater and to change the button and to make cakes by hand. So I think everything coexists. Just because you are industrialized, it doesn't mean that we are not also handmade. In I was last week in a pottery fair, and there was pottery of ceramics of all over Spain with a map of everywhere, and these cups and jars were 2 and 5 euros. That means it is still existing, this culture, today. But we think that everything is standardized. It's in the mind, you know. So I think just what helps me to survive is that I have not taken so seriously my you know, environment, that I think for myself. So it helps me here also.
Yeah. Otra pregunta.
A mí me ha gustado mucho el proceso de construcción y el envolver sobre todo a la parte social, a la gente en tus construcciones. Entonces, lo que me gustaría preguntarte es si tú como India, ¿no?, como persona que ha vivido ahí, sabemos que en los próximos 20 años se va a producir el proceso de urbanización, bueno, se está produciendo ya, ¿no?, y va a ser un crecimiento pues casi mayor que el de China. ¿Tú crees que India va a poder cambiar la mentalidad y un poco dejar de seguir este proceso de urbanización que hemos seguido en Europa, en América, y ahora conseguir una planificación un poco diferente?
I think, but I think that yes, but not because we are so good, but because we have no choice. We have not. When you have no choice, you have to be clever. I mean, when you are poor and it is a matter of your survival, you know, we cannot, we are choking ourselves, you know. So I think we cannot, even if we want, we cannot build like Europe and America did. We just don't have the energy. We don't have even the enough cement or steel, and we are not going to have it, you know. So, and the whole world is not going to have the same energy. So all the innovations we do and how many ever robots we make, we have to really think that the innovation which is not useful for the future, that will not be relevant. So I think that the problem is enormous in India, what it is, like you said. I just feel that because we don't have the luxury to have a better situation, we have the hope, maybe, that if we find a way, then everybody can redefine what is green, how green is green, if we find a way. And if we don't find a way, it's going to be very bad for many people. But you, there are so many natural disasters and so many huge problems. The people in Bombay who are homeless, the, you know, the slum dwellers and pavement dwellers, is more than the people who have houses. So this is growing. You know, we cannot, at one point, the imbalance makes you so sick that you are forced to look at it. And that could be a blessing in disguise, I hope. But maybe I hope because I am basically optimist. So it could be not a right answer, you know. I prefer to look at the good thing in it.
Yo lo que quiero, no sé si hay más preguntas, pero yo sí quiero hacer un comentario, ahora lo voy a pasar la palabra, porque yo agradezco mucho, además a Anupama, una mirada que yo me permito decir que es de alguna forma femenina, de ver las cosas y de emprender y de encarar el mundo, ¿no? Yo esto me gusta muchísimo porque pienso que es una manera distinta de cómo se han encarado muchas veces las cosas por parte, digamos, de los establishment y de lo que son las políticas, digamos, correctas, ¿no? Desde un punto de vista mundial. Entonces, esta especie de forma de encarar la profesión de una forma muy rigurosa y muy interesante, me parecen los proyectos preciosos, combinando lo que son el trabajo y la utilización de materiales, digamos, de la propia tierra y de formas de hacer de las culturas propias de los sitios, combinándolos también con tecnología, que no tiene que ser, como ella decía muy bien, no tiene que ser alta tecnología, sino tecnología discreta que se utiliza, digamos, de forma que te mejora el producto, pero no hace falta que sea ostentosa, por decirlo de una forma. A mí me parece esta mirada, aparte de es muy inteligente, pero además es que muy interesante, porque a mí me gustaría que el futuro fuera así, y te lo digo así de claro, porque es una manera positiva de ver las cosas y una manera que creo que saca, digamos, que saca lo mejor de todas las posibilidades, de las técnicas tradicionales y también de las técnicas modernas. O sea que mis felicitaciones también una vez más, me sumo yo con lo que creo a lo que piensa la mayoría, porque me parece que ha sido muy, muy interesante. Y había una palabra aquí, me parece que él la pedía y quizá ya luego cerramos este ciclo, ¿eh?
Sí, no, a mí me ha interesado la estrategia esta o el concepto de decir, dentro del presupuesto desplazo recursos de material a tiempo, y por tanto, digamos, de alguna manera ayudo a la gente, digamos, o sea, pago más las horas. Pero, digamos, esto en el contexto de la India seguramente funciona. Lo que pasa es que yo creo que en el contexto nuestro, en que el tiempo es mucho más caro que el material en muchos casos, digamos, simplemente quería que opinases en este sentido, en relación con nuestro contexto y en relación con si, digamos, en la India, con el crecimiento que ha de venir, ¿crees que el tiempo seguirá siendo tan barato como para poder seguir desplazando dinero de material a tiempo?
No, it is true, but at the same time, it is again a problem of the industrialization. That's why, because we have to maintain our machines and to have free time, which is good. I mean, I like to have a washing machine, so I have time to do something else. But it has gone to the extreme that there are many people, you're saying that the human beings' time is expensive. But there are a lot of human beings here in this country who have no job, they have time. They are not doing anything and they are not earning any money. But if they don't work, they will also become sick. They want to work. They want you like to live and do. For me, my job, the reason I have a very happy attitude to my job, I was living among a lot of problems, but in my job I'm not feeling the misery. You know, I love to create things. It's so positive. I feel so happy, and all of us are working in it's a very happy thing. So I don't feel that, you know, here also it may be luxury to do a handmade thing. I'm not promoting only handmade. I'm saying that if you see the whole picture, I came to Rawal and I was thinking, what can the people make? Because there is a lot of time, everybody is walking around, they have nothing to do. Why should they not fold the books and make a chair? It doesn't matter, it's not a bad work, it's not like being in a factory and becoming sick. they are sitting under the trees and making something nice. What is wrong with that, you know? So I think the not wanting to work has gone to an extreme that till today, I'm going to a conference tomorrow in Construmat, with where we have to talk about robots and all that, I'm sure. But the thing is, the robots are busy, but they are not solving our problem. Plus, they are taking away our jobs. So I'm trying to give the jobs while I make thing. It is a common sense for me. Also here, there are, whenever you see that there are people who have time, it is a resource. It is a resource. They don't have to make everything more handmade. But the fact is, there are a lot of people here who have a lot of time, who would make the building more nice than the robot can make it, because they do it with the feelings, you know. They don't make all equal. It's like they will have joy, they will create something nice. I think it is something, it's the two societies are not equal, but we must not extremely reject that the people work here, because then you don't be surprised if there's no jobs. Similarly, in India, we don't have to reject the machine. That's why I'm talking about the negotiation between the high tech and low tech. I'm not in favor of a standard answer. It is a question of who is available, what is available, what makes sense. If there is no energy, then you can use your own energy. You know, you can go with the cycle if there is no petrol left. But if there is, and you have something better to do, you can do it, you know. I mean, you know, you understand what I mean? I think it is something to not to assume that it's a standard situation, because even when I bought the pottery here, in, you know, the ceramic, there are many, many things which is artisanal, which is happening. Look at your food. It's the people are eating industrial bread as much as homemade bread, at least in Germany. So it's not, we have a picture of an extreme general situation, but I think it's better not to have a formula. Just each case, see what is good to do, you know. This is my approach.
Bueno, pues, thank you very much, Anupama, y muchas gracias a todos ustedes. Vamos a proseguir con la tarde porque tenemos todavía por delante unas cuantas charlas que creo que van a ser también muy interesantes. Y gracias. Hasta muy pronto. Muchas gracias. Gracias.
I don't have a card. It's anupamakundu.com. My name. Yes. You can check my detail and email. And
I made my own house with my hands.
Really?
With clay bricks.